Bonjour. Bonjour, my dearest Assumption family. Comment allez-vous? See, I told you that I won't be found only in Our Lady of the Assumption Chapel or the Friendship Garden. I am here with you. Most of you, if not all, must have been stuck at home for almost a year already because of this pandemic. Or maybe stuck in an uncomfortable or challenging situation. I understand that it is not that easy. I've been through a lot of difficult moments in my life too. But what gave me strength to endure all? Or the question must be, who gives me strength to endure all? Yes, you're right. You are thinking of the right person. I remember and always go back to that very special moment in my life when I was dressed in white in December of 1829. I remember that there were many people in the church. I received my first Holy Communion. As I returned from the altar rails, I was so worried that I would not find my mother in the crowd. I heard a voice within me saying, "Tu perdras ta mère, mais je serai pour toi plus qu'une mère. Un jour viendra où tu quitteras tout ce que tu aimes pour me glorifier et servir cette église que tu ne connais pas." Probably, I had mixed feelings at that time. Maybe also much like you these days. But I look back, that was God's first call to me. I really felt the Lord's loving presence from then until my last breath. His words in the gospel today capture my experience. "It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruits that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you." I mentioned that I went through many difficult and challenging experiences, and many times I felt stuck, even lost in situation. But it is our Lord Himself, His great love, that has been helping me to endure all those things, because I have tried remaining in His love, and in remaining in His love, I have found my joy. My dearest Assumption students, teachers, and staff, take some time today to have more quiet moments. Tell God how you feel. It's best to write this conversation in a journal. Let the Lord repeatedly say to you, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love." Listen to what He's telling you. Let His words lead you to think of concrete ways to remain in His love.